Hello everyone, today we will demonstrate different shape collision with Kotlin, and we will try to avoid edge mat mathematics as possible so that our code will be clean and easy to use. Let's get started. We create empty activity and name it basic collision, the language Kotlin with minimum SDK Android 5.1. Click finish. We will demonstrate three main type of collision: the rectangle with point, and rectangle with a circle. So in order to do that, firstly we try to create a menu so that we can switch from this collision to another type of collision. We create the menu and with the resource type menu and clicks OK. We can create our first item with the ID versus rec, the title rec vrec. The next item, the next menu item, it is rec versus point, and we name it rec versus point. And the last item is rec versus circle. Right, so here the menu. After that, we can inflate the option menu. We can return true here. Here we go, we have a menu. Next, we try to create our custom view name rec vrec. We select Kotlin class and rec vrec, and it inherits from view, and we want to create custom view, and we create the constructor with the context. Next, we try to create two rectangle variables named R1 and R2 of type rectangle, type rec. The first rectangle, we set the size of 200, 300, and for the rectangle 2, we can set 100, right? And we can create a pane object, and modify the pane with the style, with style stroke, and for the color type black. Now to draw the first rectangle on screen, we override on draw method, and here we use canvas dot draw rec. We have R1 and pane. We can change the stroke width to 5 so that it look clearer. Alright, the next thing to do is we will replace the current view with the rec vrec view. So here, rec vrec, and this. Okay, we can center rec 1 to the center of the screen by applying offset method. Offset 2 canva.width over 2 minus r1.width over 2, and for the white we use canvas.height over 2 minus r1 over 2. Okay, and here the result. We have center the rectangle to the center of the screen. Next, we will draw the second rectangle by applying the same method. Right. Next, we will move the rectangle 2 based on the mouse movement by overriding the onTouch event by using offset method, R2 offset 2 event dot x of a 2, and event y minus minus r2.height of a 2. To force our app to redraw the screen. Alright, let's see the result. Alright, now you can see that we can drag the rectangle 2 around the screen. Now we try to implement the collision detection. When R2 touch R1, we will change the color for both rectangle. So here, we can simply apply this method. I create a R2 copy equal rec R2, and I check if R2 copy intersect with R1, and I will change the paint color to red, else we set the color to default color. It means that black. Okay, so we have finished our first implementation for rec with rec collision detection without any mathematic equation. So let's see the result. Alright, so the next thing to do is to implement the rec versus point. When we click on the point outside of a rectangle, it will not do anything. But when we click inside the rectangle, we will be able to drag the rectangle. Right click, new, colon 5, rec V point, implement view, and use the context constructor. Very similar to rec with rec, we can just copy this code and paste it into our new class. We try to remove the rec 2, right? We don't want the rec 2, we just want rec 1 in the center of the screen. Here, we also need to remove the on-touch event. Right, so we modify a bit so that we can detect whether the click location inside or outside of the rectangle if R1 dot contain the event X coordinates and event Y coordinates. Right, we will change the color of the paint, else we reset the color to black. To drag it, R1. To move to new location, that is the one that we use here. I will copy it. Ctrl C, Ctrl V, and paste here. Now, what we need to do is to remove this one so that we will be able to drag it. Now, we need to change the option menu so that we can select it. R versus points, then we will set content view, rec versus point. This, if we select the menu R versus R, then we set content view to rec with rec. This. After handle the menu selection, we can test our app. Firstly, this is rec versus rec. And if we want to select rec versus point, we select the menu. Now the rec versus point is here. If we click any point outside of the rectangle, nothing happened. If we click inside, it turns red and we will be able to drag around the screen. Right? Okay. So that is the second collision. And the last one. That we somehow use simple mathematical formula in order to handle these collision. So next, we create another custom view with colon class. We name it rex v circle. We will copy the code from rec versus point here, and I paste it. Now we remove the code handling touch. Instead, we try to create our own circle class. So it is an inner class, circle, and it can be identified by two pieces of information. The center point equal point float, and the radius, we set the default value to 50. We will create an instant variable, circle, uptight circle, and then we can draw on screen in the onDraw method, draw a circle, and we use c1.center.x, c1.center.y, c1.radius, and pin. Next, we need to modify our menu so that it can select that view. r.id.rvcircle, then we set content view to rect_vcircle this. We test our app. Now we select the menu and select the third menu item, and you can see that there are a circle and a rectangle. We can move the rectangle to the center of the screen, apply the same technique with the rect_vcircle here by copy this code and paste it above the draw R1 right. Now we will make the circle draggable. We move our circle to the touch location by using the same technique, c1.center.set, event.x, event.y. Next, we will implement the collision detection between c1 and rectangle. We create a private method, collision detection, and we select create function. In this method, we will try to detect the collision between the circle and the rectangle. So we will divide it into two main cases. The first case, it is the center of the circle is inside the rectangle. Say if R1 contain c1.center.x and c1.center.y, then they are collide. So we need the local variable to save the result. Then collide equal true. So this is the easiest case. And if the center of the circle is not inside the rectangle, we compare the distance between the center and the edge. If the distance is smaller than the radius of the circle, then we have collision. Otherwise, we don't have the collision. So we will firstly create two variables to store the x and the y of the point on the edge. If p edge dot x smaller than the rectangle dot left, it means that the center point is on the left side of the rectangle, then we set the p edge dot c1 dot center dot x, then p edge dot x equal r1 dot left. Alright, we set. Else if the center is in the right side of the rectangle, right, then we set the p edge dot x equal to the right coordinate of the rectangle to float. Otherwise, we can directly assign the pH dot x to x coordinate at center point. C1 dot center dot x. Right. And very similar, we can set the y coordinates of the pH here, Ctrl C and Ctrl V, and we replace X with Y and we select it is a top. We create a delta X equal the center point, C1 dot center dot X minus P. Now pH dot x val delta y equal to C1 dot center dot y minus pH dot y, and the distance equal to mat dot sq square root of delta x multiplied with delta x plus delta y multiplied with delta y. That is a Euclidean distance. Alright, we just need to check the distance with the radius. So if distance smaller than C1 dot radius, then we have the collision equal true. We can set the result like this in a Kotlin way. Finally, after we have identified the collisions, we can update the pane. It worked perfectly. So I have shown you the basic collision between rectangle, point, and circle. We reduce as much as possible the mathematical equations and only use some built-in method. I hope you enjoy it, and I will see you in the next one.